Hello and welcome to Pilates and Yoga Fusion. My name's Amanda. Let's go ahead and get started with our warm-up. Let's come to a nice little jog, warming up our body here. All you'll need for today is a set of light weights. I'm just using 2-pound dumbbells. Feel free to go higher, go lower if you don't have weights with you. You can use a water bottle, you can use soup cans, you can use whatever you have, candles, anything of the like. I'll also be using a small ball. I recommend a non-weighted ball. You can also do weighted if you'd like. We'll have it between our hands, behind our knees, just that sort of thing. So feel free to adjust. You can also use a pillow if you'd like or a book. Let's go ahead and transition into some jumping jacks. Just warming up our body here. Of course, you can take out the hat and just step from side to side. Keeping it going. And then from here, a nice hip opener over to a side lunge. Chin and chest stays nice and lifted. Keeping it going. Let's do one more on each side. And then coming down to a low wide squat. Toes are slightly turned out. Arms reach out by your side. Reach down, tap the opposite inside ankles. Chin and chest stays lifted. Staying low in your squat, arms forward in a windmill direction. And then reverse the direction. Chin and chest stays lifted. Still staying low in your squat. Slightly hinge forward your waist, open, close your arms, giving yourself a nice big hug. Squeeze your shoulder blades as you open the arms up. And then coming down to a runner's lunge, left leg forward, pressing into that right hip, into your left knee, and then straighten your left leg, maybe point, flex your left toes, quickly switching sides, big step forward with your right foot, pressing into your left hip, and not letting your right knee pass your toes, so straighten the right leg, maybe point, flex the toes, from here. We're gonna come into our first move. No equipment is needed for our first move. Nice wide leg, toes are slightly turned out. Keep your arms up overhead for big star. We're gonna come down to a squat for goddess pose, cactusing the arms. Reach your arms up and then cactus the arms as you come into a low squat, making sure that your knees are tracking out over your toes, not passing your toes. We don't want the knees to come in. We want to keep them out nice and wide. Coming into that goddess pose, cactusing your arms as you come down into your low squat. Arms reach up overhead in opposite directions as you come up to a standing position. Keep it going. Almost there. We have these moves. We're only doing one time each for 60 seconds, so give it all you got. Push through for the full minute. Last 7 seconds, just like this. For 3, 2, and 1. Grabbing your set of light weights. From here, we have the left foot forward, right foot back. We're gonna do a single leg deadlift. So we're gonna slide that right foot back and forward as we hinge the body down below. So just keeping the right foot gliding back behind you on the floor. You can also place the ball between your palms, squeezing the ball. Go with the right leg pressing back. So with the weights in your hands or with the ball between your palms, keep it going. If you're using the ball, just making sure you're really squeezing that ball. Just gliding the right foot back and then bringing it back to starting position. Soft bend in both of your knees for 3, last 2. Coming back to a standing position, you can use the ball between your palms or you can use the weight. We're gonna do a lateral lunge. Same thing here, just sliding that right leg out as you glide the weight down in front of your left shin. So it's like a single leg lateral lunge. Keep it going. Squeezing your glutes, really drawing that right leg out to the side. as you bend even further into your left knee, gliding that weight or pressing the ball between your palms, gliding that down the front of your left shin, hinging forward at the waist, keeping it going. Just gliding the right foot out to the side, extending your leg nice and long. Last three, two, and one. Coming back up starting position. Now we have the other side. So right foot forward, left foot back, weighting your hands or press between your palms. Just gliding the weight or the ball between your palms and sliding that left leg back. Keeping it going. Core stays nice and engaged. If you'd like to use the ball, just pressing the ball elbows wide between your palms, left leg stays back. And then same thing, just gliding that ball down the front of your shin as you extend your left leg back. Hips stay facing towards the front, so we're not opening up our hips. Last five, two, and one. Still with that ball between your palms or with the weight, still working the left side leg. We're just gliding that left leg out to the left side as we draw the weight or the ball down the front of our right shin. Going to the depth that works for you. Keeping it going. Just slide it out and back up. Keeping it going. Almost there. Keeping it going. Left leg extends out as you glide the weight or the ball down the front of your right shin. Going to the depth that works for you. That left leg stays nice and straight as you extend it out from your body for three. Last two. And then with the weights in your hands, grabbing them if you haven't, don't have them already. Knees are turned out, feet are slightly wider than your hips. Coming down to a low squat position, toes are turned up, arms reach out by your side. You just have little circles, any direction. We are gonna do both directions, so no worries. Core engaged, nice flat back, chin and chest is lifted, shoulders relaxed, arms out by your side. Just holding it here and breathing. Halfway, let's switch directions. Whatever direction you're doing, just go ahead and switch that direction. Chin and chest stays lifted. Keeping it going, little circles. Opposite direction than when you started. Core stays engaged. Last five, two, and one. Setting one of the weights down, still in your wide squat. Come down nice and low, single weight in your hand, and we're gonna draw figure eight, bringing opposite shoulder down towards opposite knee as you pass that weight between your legs. Keeping it going, keeping it moving. Almost there. We're halfway. If you would like, you can switch directions. Don't think about it too much. Most important thing is that you're really crunching down, staying low in your squat, drawing your opposite shoulder to your opposite knee. Maybe it's half, maybe it just comes close. Keeping it going. Last seven, three, two, and one. Coming into a warrior stance, left foot forward, right foot back. Have a soft bend in your front left knee. Right arm comes down to the inside of your right leg. From here, we're just rowing up. So bringing that elbow up towards the ceiling. You can look down at your toes. You can look out to the side. Just try not to strain your neck. So whatever relaxes you, whatever feels good, You can also extend your left arm forward, adding a little bit more heat to your core, still drawing that right elbow up towards the ceiling so your arm stays close into your side. You're just drawing it up nice and high. Keep it going. Nice wide stance. Warrior two legs, left toes pointed out to the left side of your body, right toes pointed forward. Soft bend in your left knee. Nice straight back right leg. From the same position, keeping that elbow up nice and high. We're just extending and bending that elbow. Now working those triceps here. Elbow stays nice and lifted. Trying to get that arm as straight as you can. Just looking down, not straining your neck. Almost there. Keep it going. Still going. Keep it going. Keep it moving. Little tricep extension. Almost there. Last three, two, and one. Set the weight down, grab your ball, stand here, so with the left foot forward, you can place the ball on the floor, pressing your hands into the ball. We're gonna do a Shiva squat. So your right leg extends back behind you. From there, just drawing the right knee to the outside of your left knee, and then extend it back. You can have both hands down into the floor. If you want to add a little more heat to the core, you can grab the ball. You can also bring your hands together, pressing into the ball. The closer your hands are, the little bit more challenging it's going to be. Hips stay facing down towards the floor. Keeping it going. We're not trying to open up our hips here. Just working the outer seat. Just bending and extending the leg. You can, of course, always take that ball and place it to the side. Resting both of your hands onto the floor for five. Last three, two. Keep that leg lifted nice and straight if you can. And just little lift up. Nice, straight right leg. Keeping a micro bend in your front left knee. Don't lock out that knee. Tiny lift and lift. You can point or flex your back right toes. Core stays nice and engaged. Keeping it going. Almost there. Still going. Still moving. Little lift. Keeping it going. More than halfway through this move. Push through all the way for the full 60 seconds. Little squeezes here. Working the base of your right seat by lifting your leg up, trying to keep it nice and straight. Maybe pointing or flexing your right toes. 7 seconds to go, just like this. Core is engaged for three, two, and one. So release that right foot down, switching sides. Coming to warrior two legs again. Right foot forward, left foot back. Soft bend in your front right knee. Nice straight left leg. From here, weight in your left hand, the inside of your right foot. And then just rowing your left elbow up towards the ceiling. Just trying to look down towards your right toes, not straining your neck. Neck in neutral spine, keeping it going. Really rowing that arm up. Same thing here. We're keeping that elbow close into our side, so we're not doing a chest press, nice narrow row. Really drawing the elbow up towards the ceiling, keeping it going. Core is engaged. If you want to add more heat to the core, of course, you can draw your right arm forward, bringing all of your weight lifted, not holding on to anything for three, two, and one. Keep that left elbow up. From here, we're just going to extend and bend that left arm, working the tricep on the left side. Core is engaged. Almost there. Keeping it going. Just extending that left arm. Think about squeezing your tricep as you extend it nice and straight. elbow stays lifted. Don't let that elbow come down as high as you had it when we were doing the rows. Try to keep that elbow up just as high, just bending and extending that elbow. Elbow stays lifted. Just looking down towards your right big toe. Neck at neutral spine. Last seven, just like this, keeping it going. Palms facing in towards your body for two. Last one, gently set that weight down. You can grab the ball if you'd like. Go with your right foot forward. You can place the ball on your right or left hand, lifting your left leg up, bending your knee, bringing your left knee to the outside of your right shin, and then kicking it back. So bending and extending right back to our Shiva squat. The wider your arms are placed down into the floor, the easier it is. The closer your hands are, the more challenging it is. You can also press both of your hands into the ball. Maybe one side is easier than the other. Always trying to keep everything nice and symmetrical. Totally normal if one side feels easier than the other. Keeping the core nice and engaged. Just bending and extending that back left leg for five. Last three, two, and one. Keeping that back left leg lifted. Try to keep it straight as you can. Just tiny lift and lift. You can keep your body hinged over, facing over your right leg. Keep it nice, soft in that right knee. Don't lock out that right knee. Just tiny lift and lift. Pulling it here. Just tiny lift. Weaving the base of your left feet. Keeping it going. Tiny lift here. Keeping it going. Still moving. Working everything you can. Tiny lift and lift. Keep it going. Just lifting up. Tiny lift. Maybe pointing or flexing your back left foot for seven. Last three, two, and one. Coming on down. You won't need any equipment here. Taking off some socks so I have a little bit more grip here on the mat. Coming to our left side plank. Left hand down. We're going to stagger our bottom left leg in front of our right. Top right elbow wide behind the head. Option one, just holding this high plank. If you want to add more heat to the core, you can draw your bottom left knee up and your top right elbow down, tapping and then coming back. Whatever works for you, keep it going. Either holding that side plank or adding the oblique crunch, drawing your bottom left knee up as you simultaneously draw your top right elbow down. Maybe they tap, maybe they just come close. Keeping it going. Last three, two, and one. Draw your bottom left leg down. From here, we're going to do a clamshell and extend our leg. So as you draw that top right knee up, think about lifting and extending that leg nice and straight. You can, of course, always keep the bend in the knee. The longer the leg is, the more weight you have to disperse and the more challenging it is. Keep it going. Almost there. Clamshells opening and closing. Extending that leg out as you open the leg to add a little more heat to the core. Last 10. Keeping it going. Last two and one. From here, keeping that right leg lifted, trying to keep it straight and just pulsing up. Of course, you're gonna have a bend in the knees, dispersing that weight evenly. Keep it going, working this outer right knee on your top hip a little bit more. Keep it going. Core stays nice and engaged. Still going. still moving tiny little lifts here, either with a bent knee, your top right knee is bent, or your top leg is nice and straight, core is engaged. Just holding and breathing, maybe looking down towards your left hand. You can also look up. You can just look forward. Anything that doesn't strain your neck should be nice and relaxed. Now scrunching up your shoulders for five. Last three, two, and one. And onto your back side. From here, rolling back onto your forearms. Knees are bent, and we're gonna lift our hips up, coming into a high plank. You can also come onto your wrist. Trying to give our wrist a little bit of a break. Extend your right leg long, and then just raise and lower your right leg. So either on your wrist or on your forearm, hips are lifted for more challenge. You can also just keep your hips down the floor. You can come onto your forearms. Core stays engaged. Just raising and lowering that right leg. Keep it going. Breathing here. Last seven. Three, two, and one. Drawing the knees in. Coming all the way onto your stomach. Laying all the way down. Arms extend out overhead. Arms are wider than your shoulders. Feet are wider than your hips. From here, we're going to lift everything up and lower. So just lifting and lowering, squeezing everything to lift up. And then just as slow as you came up, releasing down, not letting your body come down faster than it came up. But think about that resistance that you're using to lift your body up or lower, to raise everything up towards the ceiling, using that same resistance to come down. 15 seconds left, just like this. Keeping it going. Last five, three, two, and one. Pressing on up. Now we have the same thing on the other side. Coming onto your right side plank. Right plank, right hand down. Extending your leg nice and long. Bottom right leg extends in front so your legs are staggered. You can have your top left hand wide behind your head. Option one is just to hold. Just holding and just breathing here in the side plank. Option two, you can draw that bottom right knee up. I'm drawing your top left elbow down. Maybe adding that oblique crunch. Maybe you tap your top left elbow down to your bottom right knee. Maybe it just comes close. Maybe you're just holding that plank, doing whatever you can today. Still going, 10 seconds to go. You got this. Push through. Holding or adding that oblique crunch for two and one. Bring your bottom right leg down. From here, bending your top left leg. So with your bottom right hand down, we have our clamshell with our leg extension. So extending that top left leg out as you draw the leg up. Option is to keep that leg bent, just pressing the weight a little bit more evenly. You should feel it in your outer left knee, keeping it going. Do you keep that knee bent or you straighten it as you extend that leg up and out? Core stays engaged. Just that left knee raises and lowers. Option to extend that knee as you raise it up towards the ceiling. Core is engaged for seven. Last three, two, and one. Keeping that left leg lifted, trying to keep the leg straight. Tiny lift and lift, really firing up that whole left side, working inner and outer legs. Of course, you can bend the knee, just working away a little bit more evenly. Maybe looking down between your thumb and your index finger on your right hand. Keeping it going, tiny lift, Left leg straight or left knee bent. Halfway there. Keep it going. Tiny lift and lift. Pushing through for the full minute here. 20 seconds to go. You got this. Keep it going. Tiny lift and lift. Working that outer seat one more time. Knee bent, knee straight, whatever you'd like. For five. Last three, two, and one. Coming on down to your back side. You can come on to your forearms or your wrist, whatever you'd like. From here, lifting the hips up, coming to that reverse tabletop position. Extend your left leg long and raise and lower. Trying to keep your hips lifted if you can, regardless if you're on your wrist or your forearms. You can, of course, always come down onto your bum. Really think about drawing in your abs, drawing your navel in towards your spine. You can come back to your forearms, giving your wrist a little bit of a break. And just raising and lowering your left leg, trying to keep your left leg nice and straight. Maybe point your toes. Last 10. Still going. Then we're gonna grab our ball. And three, two, and one. From here, we're gonna place the ball under our left knee, laying back down. Keeping your right leg straight, left leg is bent, elbows wide behind the head. From here, we have a raise and lower. So we're just doing bicycle legs, except the right leg is straight, left knee is bent, ball behind your left knee, drawing your right elbow up to tap your left knee. As you draw the left knee to the chest, right leg lower. As your right leg comes up towards the ceiling, drawing your left foot down towards the floor. Last 10. Keeping it going. Almost there for five. Last three, two, and one. Rest your head down. Both knees are bent, knees are at 90, knees are over your hips. From here, just tapping the left toe, coming back up. So just a single toe tap. Really think about pressing your lower back into the mat, pulling your navel into your spine, and then drawing your rib cage in towards the mat. Trying not to press out your abs, keeping your abs nice and engaged. If you find that your lower back lifts up, or if you have any kind of pain or discomfort as you try to tap your toe to the floor, just don't go that far. Only go as low as you can without feeling any kind of pain, any kind of discomfort. Keep it going. Almost there. Still going. Last seven. Three, two, and one. Keep that left knee bent at 90. Left knee stays directly over your hip. Now we're gonna work the right leg by extend long to a hover, draw back knee over your hip. The most important thing here is you wanna draw your knees over your hips, not closer towards your chest. As fun as it is to have more range of motion, you wanna have more resistance going on. So the closer your knee is towards your chest, the easier it's going to be. So left knee directly over your left hip, and then drawing your right knee over your right hip, and then extending it long, hovering that leg over the floor, not letting it tap. Make it way too easy. Keeping it going. Almost there. Still going. You can rest your head down, just gazing up towards the ceiling. If you would like, you can also tuck your chin. Imagine you have a clementine under your chin. With that right leg straight, left leg stays bent, left knee over your hip. That leg has not moved for a full minute. Now we're just raising and lowering that right leg. So same thing we did before, this time we're just laying all the way down. You can have your neck rested, flat on the floor, looking up to the ceiling. You can also curl up, crunching, So trying to keep some distance between your chin and your chest. Imagine you have a clementine under your chin. You don't want to squeeze it. You don't want it to burst. Keep it going. Almost there. Just raise and lower that right leg. Right leg stays nice and straight. Right leg comes straight up towards the ceiling, maybe pointing the toes, and then lowering that right leg down to a hover. Keep it going. Last seven, three, two, and one. Grab the ball from behind your left knee. Press the ball into the top of both your thighs, thighs are together. From here, you have alternating toe taps, and then pressing that ball into the knee that's staying bent at 90. Knee does not come closer towards your chest. It stays directly over your hip. Really feeling your core engaged here. Feeling everything nice and tight. Halfway there. Alternating toe taps. Ball into the top of your left thigh as your right toe taps. Ball into the top of the right thigh as your left toe taps. And just alternating. Keeping it going. Tiny taps. Think about pressing your lower back into the mat. Going strong for 10. Then we have the other side. Still using that ball. We're going to use the ball for the rest of class. And 3, 2, and 1. Placing that ball behind your right knee. Your right knee is bent at 90. Extending your left leg long. Elbows wide behind the head. Raise and lower that left leg as you draw that right knee up towards the ceiling. So single leg bicycle. Both legs are moving. Drawing your left elbow down as your left leg goes down and drawing your right knee up. Trying to tap left elbow to right knee. So opposite legs. Keeping it going. Still going. Still moving. Moving here with your breath. Single leg bicycle. Weight stays behind your right knee. Right knee stays bent. Last five. Left leg long and straight for 2 and 1. Both knees bent at 90. Just resting your head down. Left leg stays completely still. Left knee over your hip. Right knee over your hip. And then tap your right toes. Coming back, bringing your right knee over your right hip. So just the left leg is moving. Really keeping that knee bent, squeezing that ball. Core is engaged, so you're not allowing your abs to concave up towards the ceiling. Pressing your belly button in towards your spine. Lower back pressed into the mat. Think about pressing your back into the earth. Keeping it going. 20 seconds just like this. Left leg stays completely still. Isometric hold. Still working that left leg just by holding it. Almost there. Keeping it going. Still going. From here, right knee stays bent. We're just going to bend and extend that left leg. So now your right leg stays completely still. Right leg is not moving. Right knee still behind the right knee. Right knee directly over your hip. Left knee comes over your hip and then extends long to a hover, not letting either one of your knees come closer to your chest. It should come directly at 90, knees over your hips, and then returning back. Extending and bending just that left leg. Right leg is completely still. Really think about pressing your lower back into the mat as you extend that leg long. Being mindful, working your core. Really firing up the abs here. Keep it going. Just extend and bend. Almost there. Still going. Hold that left leg straight. Just raise and lower that left leg. Keeping it going. Almost there. Still going. Just raise and lower.
Still going. Almost there.
We're engaged. Firing up that core. 20 seconds to go. Almost there. Still going.
Just that left leg raised and lowered. Last 3, 2, and 1.
Grab that ball. Place the ball between your thighs, resting your feet onto the floor. Really trying to get your legs nice and narrow, squeezing that ball. Palms resting down by your side. Upper back stays pressed into the mat the whole time. Squeezing your feet to lift your hips up towards the ceiling. Just lift and lower. Soles of your feet pressed into the floor. Core is engaged. Think about somebody that has a string on top of your hips and they're drawing it up towards the ceiling, engaging your core as you lift. Keeping it going. More than halfway through this move. Still there, still going. Moving and breathing, working everything all at the same time. Still going. Last 5, 3, 2, and 1. Grabbing up ball.
Coming up to a tabletop position. We're going to place that ball behind your right knee and really squeezing your heel towards your seat to keep it there. Hands are directly under your shoulders. Knees are under your hips. From here, flexing your right toes. And then just little donkey kicks up. So pressing the sole of your foot up towards the ceiling, squeezing that ball, keeping your heel in towards your seat. Core is engaged, nice flat back, not arching your spine. Hips stay facing down. You can come onto your forearms too if you want to give your wrist a little bit of a break. Still pressing the sole of your foot up by flexing your foot. Heel stays up towards your seat. Just pressing up to the ceiling. Keeping it going. Little presses up. Last 3, 2, and 1. Boxing out your right arm, bringing your left forearm onto the floor. If you haven't done so already, opening up your hips. Go with your heel to your seat. Your left leg is lifted. And then we have little lifts here. Working that outer seat one more time. Keeping it going. Just little lifts. Toes are flexed. Left heel to your seat. Really keeping that ball just where it's at. Core is engaged. Boxing out your right arm. Left forearm is down onto the floor. Left. Keep it going. Just little lifts and lifts. Still going. Still moving. Few more just like this. And we're going to switch sides. Doing the same thing on the other side for 10. Last 5, 3, 2, and 1. Gently releasing your right leg down, grabbing that ball, placing the ball this time behind your left leg, drawing your left heel to your seat, flexing your left heel, wrists are under your shoulders, right knee under your hips, squeezing your seat, lifting your left seat up. Hips stay facing down towards the floor. Think about your hips as headlights and are trying to guide you along the way. You can stay on your wrist, just looking down between your thumb and your index fingers. You can also come down onto your forearms, looking down between your forearms. Nice flat back, not arching your spine. Sole of your foot is pressed up towards the ceiling. Imagine you're trying to stamp the sole of your foot up towards the ceiling. Really pressing your heel up, heel towards your seat, and then keeping your knee nice and high for 5. Last 3, 2, and 1. Bring your right forearm down. If it is not already down, box out your left arm. Open up your left hip. So your hips are now facing 90-degree angle, and then little pulses up. Working that outer seat. Trying not to press through on the right side. Just looking up, looking out, maybe looking down. Anything to relax you. nice flat back, core is engaged. Keep it going, halfway there. Squeezing that ball, keeping your heel to your seat, flexing your left toes. Left hip is lifted up, 90 degree angle. Left knee is fluttering in the wind. Keeping it going, imagining that your left knee, your left hip is waving. Last 10. Keep it going. For 5. Last 3, 2, and 1. Gently release that left knee down. Grab that ball. Just set it to the side. And then coming to a wide-legged child's pose. Knees are wider than your hips. Feet together. Extend your arms out long out in front of you. And then placing your forehead down towards the mat. Enjoying that stretch. And then coming up to a tabletop position, wrists are under your shoulders, knees are under your hips, tucking your toes and tucking your hips up, coming into a down dog, pressing your heels into the floor, lifting your toes, and then lifting your heels, pressing your toes and the pad of your feet into the floor, and then alternating. Move them, switch with each knee. Hips stay nice and lifted. Gaze is towards your navel or your thighs. With both heels pressed in down towards the floor, walking your hands back towards your feet. You can have a soft bend in your knees. You can also have your legs straight. You can grab opposite elbows and sway side to side for a lower back release. Maybe shake your head yes, maybe shake your head no. Extend your arms long down towards the floor if you have them wrapped and roll it up slowly one vertebrae at a time. Roll your shoulder blades back, roll them forward. Nice big deep breath. One more for good luck. Awesome. Thank you so much for joining me today. This is Yoga Pilates Fusion. My name's Amanda. Hope to see you all again. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. Make sure to stretch. Make sure to drink plenty of fluids.